Welcome back to Soccer 360. This is the second part of this show. Now, of course, the first part, we've got into a heated argument back on the set, me, Salim, Ba, and Nicolette. But as for now, we have moved in. We are going to be discussing the big game of the day, that is Tottenham Hotspurs against City at the Etihad Stadium. Now, I'm joined here by Salim. We're going to be going through both squads. We'll start off with the City squad. Given he's a City fan, I'd like him to tell me, first and foremost, is this squad, do you think this is a squad Guardiola will go with today against Tottenham?
Rumors have it, or reports have it, that he's going to have Rodrigo Hernandez and Fernandinho sit just to get that surety at the back, in front of that that back four. And when you look at last weekend, when we were ripping West Ham apart 5-0, Bernardo Silva didn't play. He was keeping him fresh
for this game.
Yeah, for this big one, because he puts in double shift, game in, game out. So if you look at this team, I think David Silva will be in there. De Bruyne will be in there. And then there'll be Fernandinho and Rodrigo. And then I think today, Mahrez.
He'll have to give up one player here.
Yeah. And then Sterling, I think, in my opinion, Sterling is going to play as a number nine. So basically, it's just the same team that, more or less the same team that played last last weekend. But that will be definitely be it. So.
And. Why is this? Okay. Yeah. And from this squad, this lineup, so Mahrez comes out in favor of
Bernardo Silva.
Bernardo Silva.
Yeah.
And then for Fernandinho to come on, someone has to be sat out. Jesus?
Jesus has, because you saw last weekend in the Community Shield, he played with Sterling as a false nine.
As a false nine.
You get that pace up front, and he will have De Bruyne sit in front of Rodrigo and Fernandinho, because you know De Bruyne can pick passes all day. David Silva is an artist. You have Bernardo Silva, he'll put in work and also is an artist. And then you have the pace of Sterling up front. I think Tottenham are in big, big trouble today.
So my worry with City is actually this backline. I think Laporte is an excellent defender.
Yeah.
This man right here, John Stones, he has a lapse. He sometimes just loses concentration and focus. Is this the weak point for City?
Yeah, because I think when Vincent Kompany left the team for Anderlecht in Belgium, I think this guy was supposed to be replaced with a much more better defender. Because if you look at Stones, yes, on the ball, Pep Guardiola likes players that are good on the ball. But if you look at his defensive responsibilities, he takes care of nothing in this back line. So, but that's why you have Laporte, because he has
a pace. Excellent. He is very good.
He can cover up for his mistakes. But then again, you look at that back line, Delvin. You have pace and precision in there.
Is Cancelo fit? That's another player I'd like to see in this City squad.
Yeah, Juan Cancelo. And it's also an option, because Walker is his versatility. You can play him as a central defender, and Juan Cancelo can play out wide.
So another last question on City before we go to Spurs lineup. In defence, I know it's probably a rather obvious question. Would you rather have Stones or Otamendi?
I will have Stones
all any day. Yes, Otamendi seems to be. He just gets too rash at times.
He reminds me
of a David Luiz of sorts. Now, let's look at the Tottenham lineup. Do you think the squad they're going to go with is Vertonghen fit? Was he in the bench in the previous game?
Vertonghen, he's fit.
And Alderweireld is as well. He's fit. So
he's back and fit. But I think today Eriksen will play. Will play as a 10. So because of his quality. So basically, when you have Eriksen, you have someone who can pick passes and just pick out the likes of Harry Kane.
Yeah.
Because if you look at this Tottenham side, with we know Son is out injured, he has a ban, he's serving his last match ban today. If you have Son out, you must have Eriksen in there. And this guy, Ndombele, he's a proper player.
Now, definitely Eriksen should start, given that against Aston Villa, they looked toothless up front until Eriksen came in and he just changed the game completely.
Yeah.
This midfield worries me, though. If I'm not a fan of wings, and I'm not a fan playing City, I wouldn't recommend Pochettino go with two up front, and leave the midfield a bit exposed, because he'll be run ragged in that midfield with the likes of De Bruyne and Co.
Today, I think that's why you'll have wings. I think he'll be out of the team today. He will let Sissoko and Ndombele
sit there.
Yeah, because you have that protection, and then you can have Eriksen on top of that diamond,
and then you can have all
this pace of Lucas Moura and out wide.
You being a City fan, I want to ask you, apart from Kane, and of course Son is injured, because me, if I was to be asked as an Arsenal fan, when you face Spurs, would you fear that Spurs side? And I normally go Son. Son really just fear. He gives me the chills. But anyway, Son is out. other than Kane, with this team, and Eriksen, with this team, other than those three, can cause City problems?
I've come to think time and time again, it has got to be also this guy, Danny Rose. Because of how much ground he covers each and every single game. And if you give him time on the ball, he'll pick that cross all day, every day. But then again, you talk about the Son that are out, but you've got to talk about Christian Eriksen, because he can. If you give him time, he can run the show.
Now, another question. Spurs' weakness in this squad, fullback Walker Peters, do you think that's the area of weakness and City will be looking to attack down that side?
Yeah, absolutely. If I was Mauricio Pochettino, I will start Serge Aurier in here. Because
I heard that he's not 100% fit for this game.
But if he's fit, that is.
Yeah, he'd have to play him
because he has all that pace and that power. Because you're coming up against the Bernardo Silva, the Raheem Sterlings, you've got to have your best wing backs in the game. If you don't do that, this guy is inexperienced. Against City, he'll be picked off.
He'll be picked off. And I think that is an area that Spurs had to, after selling Trippier, they needed to strengthen that position.
Absolutely.
Okay, last question on Spurs. Do you see Lo Celso given some game time today?
Yeah, he should, because the Real Betis former player is his top quality, the Argentinian. He has all the quality in the world. And you look at a team that has all the pace. There's pace in here.
There's pace, yeah.
There is pace. You've got to find that someone that, when you give him the ball, you are sure that Kane will make that run and he'll pick him off.
Then also it will actually reduce some weight on
Christian Eriksen.
So, because Lo Celso can also just playmaker as well. Yeah. So now, okay, you've heard it from me and Salim regarding the team and lineups. Now we'll want to take a look at Pep Guardiola and Mauricio Pochettino's press conferences ahead of today's big game. Now those are the thoughts of Pep Guardiola and Mauricio Pochettino ahead of today's huge clash at the Etihad Stadium, pitting City, of course the champions, and the Champions League finalists from last season, Tottenham Hotspurs. Now before I get my pundit's thoughts on this, I just want to take you through a few of the feedback we've been getting on Twitter. And I'll start by at Kelly Gitai, who says, my top six weekend matches score predictions. And it starts with Arsenal 2, Burnley 0, another clean sheet for Arsenal. That will be very, very welcomed. Southampton 1, Liverpool 3. City and Spurs to draw 2-2. You might have something to say about that. Chelsea, Leicester to draw 1-1. And United to beat Wolves 2-0. That game, of course, being played on Monday. Other comments coming from Gemma Jones. It's been long since I've seen you all on set. It feels good to see you guys back in business. Talking football, tuned in from Nakuru as always.
Thank you.
A shout out to. Yes.
Shout out, our bad.
Okay, just
shut up.
You don't know what you're going to do anyway.
I don't know what's wrong with this guy, but I feel like he needs a therapist.
Never get a bit whopper.
No, I think he needs a therapist. Like, I'm really concerned right now.
You do need a therapist.
I don't.
So anyway, let me continue with
the... ground nuts on set.
Let me continue with the feedback. Gemma Jones as well goes ahead and says, I actually think Man United are good with Sanchez. Sanchez not scoring enough doesn't mean he's a flop. In matches, he always makes the key passes, has nice crossing and important dribbles to set up chances for the team.
Which
kind
Sanchez
of agree,
is that?
But then again, if
I don't see him.
But then again,
that's the one for FIFA.
That's clear.
I think that's a FIFA
or
Sanchez.
The one that was playing at Arsenal.
For Gemma Jones, I think if you compare, if you just have to look at his performances at Arsenal and what he's doing at Manchester United to know that he's not performing at his best. That's all you have to do.
It's just because he doesn't fit. He's not a fit for the team.
Nicolette, unasema
that we are discussing
FIFA.
Salim and Nicolette decided that it's the philosophy in the team that, in the style of play that doesn't go with.
That time, I agreed with you.
No, that time your mic was actually switched off. So.
Oh my God.
let me read the final comment here again from Gemma Jones again. I thought nearly Diemba asingilie Arsenal sana. Stop talking about us. You are too much. Woy. Hashtag
success. No wonder you find Sanchez a good player. I get it.
Anyway, those are the comments. But now, let's just get back to discussions. Now, you've heard what Pep Guardiola and Mauricio Pochettino had to say. And since I've been discussing with Salim in the screen all along, aren't you two, your thoughts on this game? And how do you see this game panning out?
I always say when Spurs and City meet, it's always the trickiest game in
very
the season.
Tricky.
Because I always say it's you know, when you wake up in a bad mood, you go back to sleep and wake up on the right side of the bed. That's how it is with these teams. It depends on who wakes up on the right side of the bed is always going to win that game.
You don't favor City being at home even? And having a slight, okay, not slightly.
You know,
the thing is
with City and Spurs, they all have one or two key players who can change the game. Or the result between the two of them.
What I can say,
I always say it's always a tricky game to call.
Absolutely.
What I can say is for their past five meetings in the Premier League, they've City have not been beaten.
Yeah.
Has beaten them four times and drew once. And I think this can, you know, continue because City are better side, maybe compared to Tottenham right now.
Sure.
But again, ile mood ya last season na ile machungu yote yenye wamekuwa nayo, Champions League and whatever, I think might come back. So pia City naweza ongezea kwa sababu ndio iko na machungu na Tottenham most.
Yeah, people have been talking. It's been termed as the revenge for the Champions League.
Might act as a revenge.
It's payback time. It's really payback time. But then again, you look at Mauricio Pochettino. He has a very good record against Pep, even when they were in the
record.
Spanish La Liga.
Yeah.
So, but I think today, if Mauricio Pochettino wants to go toe-to-toe with Pep Guardiola, I think he will bury him. He has just got to go there and sit back and read the game because you don't want to go toe-to-toe with that Man City side because they'll
you
rip
really
you apart.
But given...
But you see, that's why I said they'll always have that one player that can switch up the things because you guys have a player that you keep on the bench who everyone forgets about, who Pep usually uses. No. They have a player that they use to as a game changer. I always say he's Pep's secret weapon.
De Bruyne?
Foden.
Why, Foden.
And then with Maurizio, he has Lucas Moura.
Why we are saying City is a better side? Because you look at the artists are in that midfield. You have Kevin De Bruyne, you have David Silva, you have Bernardo Silva, you have a Mahrez that can rip teams apart, you have a Sterling. If you look at this Tottenham side, if Eriksen doesn't pick those passes, they're in big, big trouble.
Like
and again, Lucas Moura,
you
want to let him go, though.
I feel like Lucas Moura is there. Although, them not having Son does favour City.
It does favour City.
Because of his pace and the way
he really
but then, also, Lucas Moura is not a... Is I feel like he's their wild card.
But
the same way you guys have Foden as your wild card.
The question is, will he start today? And it depends with where you play him. If you play him on the Walker side, Walker is as quick as anyone.
Yeah.
So you have to play him on a side. If he plays on the Zinchenko side, Zinchenko is not a very quick player.
But he's actually very good.
But again,
that's where they'll have the joy. So it depends with where you play that Lucas Moura. Because if you take him on the right side, I think
And do you think Lamela will start?
For me, the key player maybe
Dele
Alli
is out.
Who might shine most is Harry Kane. In this situation.
Oh my goodness. Why?
I think he might shine,
you know,
Nicole against Man City.
She doesn't like
Kane. I even have a headache coming on.
She does not like Kane.
Because Kane is
Kane
not
is
a player who can. You see, when you're playing a team like City, you do not rely on someone like Kane. Kane never shines.
But
Kane, he's not a player
Kane,
who can go
Kane
and get the ball and do
Kane
anything
never
with it.
In the usual matches. Kane shines in such matches versus Man City where he comes in and scores.
Oh my goodness.
Story.
I have a question for Salim.
I don't know. I'm City when I shined a basi.
I have a question for Salim. Kane is top class. Top quality player. How many goals has he scored against City? Because I don't remember.
The last time he scored.
Who scores against? Who is the wild card for Spurs when it comes to them meeting City?
Son.
It's Yuen Ming Son.
Harry Kane, my friend, and Ashanigi.
Son is not. Son is not there.
He's not playing anyway.
Today it will even get worse because Harry Kane won't even have a touch on the ball because that's why you see Pep is going with two holding midfielders. So he wants to shut down Eriksen. And make sure Ken, because Ken is not that kind of striker that will come like the Benzema, the Lewandowski,
no,
pick the ball and
score. Yeah, he doesn't.
He has
he's
to
a
get that service
striker.
From someone.
Yeah.
If you shut down the service, he won't even be seen on that football field.
Okay, now,
I'm not a Ken fan. Before I give you
your predictions, did you check the lineup? Is Pepe playing?
No. He's not starting. And your backline
is
pathetic.
Pepe is not starting.
And your backline is pathetic. Like you guys are winning this game because you're playing at the end.
So it's okay. You know, I had so much psych to go with this game. So I'm starting right now. So Pepe is not starting.
But your boys are there.
In my opinion, I think Unai Emery smokes the best Jamaican breed weed.
No, he doesn't. He's the person who gives them a bad name. He must be sniffing something. You can have the best players in the world, but if you don't know how to position them.
Of discussion. Let's go with the rundown. Let's follow the rundown.
Okay, bro.
Now, predictions. Man City versus Spurs.
I think Man City will win.
Man City scoreline?
2-1.
2-1 to City. You think it'll be a close game?
There's nothing like 4.
You think it'll be a close game, 2-1 to City?
My friend. Yeah.
Okay, Nicolette.
Me, I'm going to be a bit more generous and say I'll give City the win, but 3-2.
3-2 City. So
yeah.
Still a close one. That'll be an interesting game. It would be an interesting game. It's 5 goals.
Sinikama 2 young.
For neutrals, Delvin, as Nicolette is saying, 3-2. This is a perfect game.
Yeah.
The best attacking football you're ever gonna see. So.
Of course, it's not Manchester United. We'll just sit back. So anyway, it'll be an interesting game.
I might
we are not in that topic of discussion.
Yeah,
I might just go for 4-2.
4-2. Oh, he's reading my mind. That was my prediction, actually.
He's not reading your mind.
Devin, have you ever predicted? No, it has. Devin, have you ever predicted less than four for whoever is winning, whenever you predict? Never.
He has said less than a 4-1.
No, but anyway.
It's like everyone is Liverpool in the EPL for Devin.
I'm going for 4-2. I think there'll be goals in that game. Yeah, they will. Coming out top.
And then we end up finding it's a goalless draw. Oh, at Nalala halfway.
I'm hoping not.
Ujaman has a car indoors for a whole week.
That one I'm certain.
Okay, now there you've been attacking teams. You're attacking Man United, Arsenal.
I'm not attacking.
You're City's case. Now it's time to talk Chelsea.
Talk Chelsea.
Chelsea playing Leicester. But before anything else, I want you to hear what your manager, Lampard, had to say before the big game, actually on Sunday. So, my director, please let us have a look at what Lampard and Brendan Rodgers had to say during their press conferences. Now, those are the thoughts of Brendan Rodgers and Frank Lampard. Of course, this game being played on Sunday, Chelsea vs Leicester, hot game. Let's not forget, the Foxes went to Stamford Bridge last season and got a victory. So, my Prince, what do you have to say about that? No Hazard in the team, playing a team that did win in Stamford Bridge last season, that a team that has actually strengthened their squad. How do you see this game going for Chelsea?
Bro, this is the time we are beginning our 2019-2020 season. We are winning we are starting with a win. And I'm not talking this just because we lost two of our matches, or previous matches. I'm saying this because I'm seeing better things at
the
Chelsea.
Performances are there. Right? The performances are there.
There's that determination. There's that kujitolea. There's that hearts which are, you know, bleeding inside them. The blue color is bleeding just inside the players. And I think this is
which
what...
Which blue? Define which blue. Because there's the sky blue, then there's the Chelsea blue.
To H with the whatever we are seeing here. This is the sky. I am talking about the round.
Have some respect when you're talking about champions.
You people,
I'm not seeing between guys, these guys.
Continue.
Ever.
Don't focus on
Sunday. Don't mention mid the sky.
Okay, continue your thoughts. Continue your thoughts.
So the blue, the Chelsea is the color. I mean, you can see in the eyes of N'Golo Kante. He is back. I'm very happy.
And one again, thing, let me just cut you out there.
Another thing.
Okay, let me cut you short there. One thing that I read from Lampard that just made me, I just burst out.
Yes.
In the 105th minute, he was saying Kante told him that his legs are done.
Yes.
He couldn't run anymore.
Yes.
And then a minute later, he sees Kante sprinting. How many yards was it to go and recover the ball? Kante is a player. That is the best, probably the best holding midfield in the world.
He literally is.
Yes, probably.
Yes.
He literally is.
But again, don't so forget that Pedro did the same.
He played well.
From the first minute to the last minute.
But now, I want you to focus. Let's focus on this Leicester City game.
Yeah.
It's Leicester, we normally categorize them with the Wolves. Everton and West Ham.
I don't think you can categorize them as the Wolves.
No, like
so
I'm saying, we categorize
they're
them
higher,
together.
They're higher quality
Leicester,
than...
Leicester, okay.
Yeah.
But I'm saying we categorize them together with the Wolves and Everton because they're in that pack just below the top six. They gave teams headaches and they did beat you at Stamford Bridge last season. They have strengthened their squad.
They beat us once. We beat them in the third match.
Yeah, but you're talking about Stamford Bridge now. They did win there.
Yes. What I can say about here, I'm so happy about our midfield because Kante went back to where he belongs. That is the deep six. And that is how he played against Liverpool. The Kovacic and Jorginho or Kombele Ake. That is the way I wanted it.
You reminded me of another thing. Lampard also touched on the issue of
playing
Kante number six.
Yes.
Because against Liverpool, he didn't play number six. He was on the right-hand side of the
three. He was in the deep.
Because Lampard...
And he wanted to change because he was so...
Yeah, Lampard said that he doesn't want to restrict Kante.
Yes.
By playing him on the six. That restricts him to only defensive work and to just sit in front of the back four. So he'd rather play him on the sides where he has... The license to roam around.
But again, of course, the instruction was that yes, Kante, you're on number six, but you're free. So Jorginho alikuwa anakuja kucover. So that Pedro anacheza ile nafasi ya number eight and whatever, kuchukua balls, kusonga nazo, na kuleta maybe cross on the flanks and whatever. But Kante should be very free in that midfield. So that anaweza recover for anybody. All right? So that is why I'm so happy. And I think we can do better than how we did last season.
Okay, now let me get... Neutral fans, their perspectives on this game.
There's no neutral City. Fans. There's a haters.
Oh, oh my
there's
God.
There's no neutral fans.
But I think, honestly, see, you just let us talk. Yeah. What if we were giving you guys a win?
But you guys are haters.
Okay. Relax.
Ones are the sky blues.
Relax. Now, your perspectives on this game. Do you think Kante should be put on that number six, given Leicester's midfield? Three. Madison, Tielemans, Didi. Where do you think Kante will fit properly in this Chelsea midfield? Deep six? Or in either side of the number six with the license to roam?
You know, to be honest with you, I would rather not have him in the deep six.
Yeah.
I'd give him the license to roam. Because this is, I always say Leicester is the trickiest of tricksters.
Yeah, they have a good midfield. My God.
Yeah.
Where do you see Salim?
But he needs to belong somewhere.
For me, with a central defense of Kurt Zouma and Christensen, they are very sluggish players. I will have Kante as a holding midfielder because you have Maddison and Tielemans. These are players that can hurt you. They can really hurt you. You don't have that protection in front of that back four. So I think for me, Lampard is a through and through Chelsea boy. Over the years, we have seen the Claude Makélélés, the Ramirez. These are seasoned holding midfielders. So you've got to have a holding midfielder first and then build players around him. And that's what he did against Liverpool. He just let Kante sit and cut short all those passes and then have Jorginho and Kovacic to
play. Another thing, Jorginho is a liability in that position. He is a huge liability. He's so slow on the ball. But if by any chance Jorginho is underplaying that position, I think your defense will have a problem.
But again, you know what? I think Pulisic has brought another, a big impact in that match.
He played well. He did play well.
Because unapata Jorginho, however he is good, yes, but creativity yake iko down. So Pulisic anakuja ku compliment. And again, when you're having Kante on that holding midfield, ana spoil. Kazi yake ni tackles, ana win balls, Jorginho, Pulisic then through passes. For the first time, I've never seen, guys, if you watch Liverpool versus Chelsea, you could see in the first half tulikuwa tunaweza kupika through passes between Matip and Virgil van Dijk. It was very possible. Thanks to Pulisic, Jorginho and Kante.
But generally, without no fear, no favor, Chelsea are playing better football. And when you watch them play, one problem they have at the moment, we have a Manu that we talk about, they didn't buy this player, but they have a Rashford and a Martial that when you pick him off, he'll score a goal. Yeah. That's the problem Chelsea
have. They don't have a consistent number nine.
If they would have gotten a consistent number nine, like you look at right now, Manchester United might not play the best football, but if you pick Rashford off, he will score a goal. Chelsea don't have that.
But again, Salim, I think for maybe to Kimpatia some time, I think he'll come and merge together.
A consistent blend number well. Nine. Yeah, yes, who can score goals?
But then again, you guys can play Giroud in that particular position because he's much more seasoned.
And I think I'll agree with that.
Yeah, because Giroud would be your finisher, basically.
You saw Abraham.
No.
Giroud could finish.
Imagine you need someone like Giroud.
His movement.
Did you see his movement against Liverpool? Even for the goal. Did you see how he peeled?
How many chances did he spoil?
No, but how many times does Giroud do that? And then you can use him like as a wall. Yeah. Even Hazard had said this. Just ping pong the ball off.
Again, guys, we struggle when you're having Giroud. We struggle. Ata kishika ball. We're not sure that.
With Giroud, you're lucky because you have a Pulisic and the Pedros and the Williams. These are players, attackers who all can score goals. So just build that play around Giroud.
But again,
Tammy Abraham for me is way inexperienced. Yeah. You even see the kind of chances he had against Leo. He doesn't know what to do. You should shoot fast or pass fast. That inexperience is what will cost Chelsea. But if you play Giroud, trust me, you can tweet Lampard today. You have a chance.
I love Giroud. I really don't hate him.
I feel like you underutilize him. And with Lampard in that position, I feel like he will play him as... honestly, you need experience against Leicester.
Come out to Hurricane. Anangojiaga.
But at least I will disagree with you. Oh. Giroud is not like Kane because Giroud can play a midfield position unlike Kane who cannot.
You remember. We all remember the World Cup. We were complaining. Giroud should not play.
Giroud is built around him.
France won the World Cup. No, you don't get our point.
Imagine Giroud is the person you need to change that game.
He's a physical presence in the box in himself. If you deliver crosses, you are sure he will score two or three chances.
Let me tell you the problem with Ba. Ba has a personal issue against Giroud. But Giroud is the one who's going to change that game
for you guys.
Why are you going against what even your best player had said in Hazard?
Look.
He enjoys playing with Giroud.
Yeah, he was much comfortable.
Look, guys. Hiyo kitu yenye unasema he doesn't have to score. That is why he's there. Sisi kama wa mashabiki, sisi ndio tunaumia.
Wanaujuma.
Sisi ndio tunaumia. Ujuma. Kama coach kituambia ati enjoy, sisi tunataka kuona hiyo ball imeshikwa. And that is why we enjoyed it. We loved it when Drogba was there.
If you keep on playing Tammy Abraham.
Let me tell you, if you keep playing Tammy Abraham,
you guys will score nothing against no one.
You just be playing that beautiful football and no result.
Yes.
But it is the same na Giroud bana.
Giroud scored against Liverpool. That one chance he took it.
Alipoteza chances.
But he scored the most important goal, the first goal. Didn't he score?
He did, yes. Then he did, and I was happy about it. But again, you score once in 20 chances that you have.
Let's see this. the viewers, but you have to look at it. There's more to just scoring goals to an attacker. Look at the movement of the player, how the player combines with the players around him. He is better than Abraham. At right now, what you have, Giroud would be the first choice striker.
Exactly.
Guys, get to my point clear. Salim, I'm not saying, listen to what I'm saying. I'm not saying that Giroud is bad. No, Giroud is okay.
So you prefer Tammy Abraham?
I prefer him in this way. Tupatie chance mtu mwingine tuone what he can do.
Okay, he's Chelsea. That's his team. There's no need for us to argue with him on that. Tupatie chance mtu mwingine.
Ameanza game mbili, tumeona dalili, tuone labda ya
There's no need. And probably I don't think even after the racial abuse he got, I don't think Graham Lampard will drop him for this game. Just saying. But I'd prefer, personally, Giroud in the center.
Aanze, alafu Tammy
akuje. Nikoleta as well and Salim
Wacha wawe wanaanza hivyo. Tammy aanze, Giroud akuje.
Let's focus on Leicester. Where do you see this side? Leicester can't hurt Chelsea. Of course, there's Vardy up front with the pace. There's a midfield of
Madison. There's a midfield that is so strong.
They have a very good midfield. Where do you feel, Bob Prince, as a Chelsea fan, you look at this Leicester side, where in that area do you see, in the squad of Leicester, where do you fear? Vardy, of course?
The striking force, Vardy. But again, I don't fear the midfield because if we have encounter there, spoiling and whatever can happen. And then
they also have Didier on the other side. Don't forget, very talented. He can just mark up Barkley and the Kovacic.
But that is why we are taking this match as a competitive one because both sides are strong. And we are so... I'm not saying that we are not afraid of Leicester. We are afraid of... Because this is a match. And anything can happen because our Sewa Najua, how we are playing. They've seen us for the past two matches. So me, I'm afraid for the ile build-up in Yenatoka Pale Nyuma to the striking force. Yahawa kina Leicester. So if we do mistakes, they can maximize on our mistakes. Maybe if it happens again, like what Manchester United did, it is not that we were, our side, but we were good, yes. But what happened, ilikuwa mistakes, then Manchester United will maximize. So if it happens again this time around, Leicester City watatupiga.
Okay, now I need...
We are both good.
Even where do you see Leicester before we get to the predictions? Where do you see Leicester hurting Chelsea and in which area?
You saw against Leicester against Everton, they are so scared of committing bodies forward because they don't have a Harry Maguire. Yeah. Back last season
against Wolves,
against Wolves, they could commit bodies forward last season because they don't. Harry has that calm as a defender and he has that physical presence. And you have now only Morgan who should be dealing with problems.
Yeah.
And then you have all that pace up front, all Brighton. You have all Brighton, and you have Jamie Vardy. And we have talked about the same. I don't think Kurt Zouma, for me, you saw what he was doing.
He's a
liability. He was better against Liverpool, but...
I don't know.
Against Man United, they realize he's too slow and he commits himself into tackles too quickly. If you do that against the Tielemans, the Madisons will just let you commit and pick that pass to Vardy. Yeah. So I think it can't go either way today because if Chelsea, as we talk, they don't have a striker who can score goals, I think today... Leicester might just go there and sit and play, and they might just hurt them with all that pace.
If they sit and play, we will beat them.
Nicolette, no, your thoughts.
Let me weigh in on this. If Lampard is watching this show, let me be optimistic, and he decides to pick Giroud, Chelsea will win against Leicester. But if they don't, I don't see a draw.
You see a Leicester victory.
I see a Leicester
victory. Now that you've gone into the predictions,
a hater.
Scoreline.
No. I'm not a hater, I'm a realist. No, I just there's a difference.
Everyone is entitled to
my friend. Opinions.
Let me face you and tell you this. if Lampard at a pick, Tammy Abraham, Amweke Pale, Tammy will try to prove himself against what he did at the penalty in Yalipoteza. And I am telling you, Tammy might score even two goals. I am telling you.
You know the thing is that Bernard is not getting.
So, no. Sour. But if he does put Tammy Abraham over Giroud, you guys are losing to Leicester.
We are not losing.
Imagine
because
you
this is not Liverpool.
Scoreline.
Liverpool was a strong side,
Nicolette,
than Leicester.
You're giving your prediction.
You know, you're forgetting. United played like 20% of game. Yeah. Like they did it so effortlessly, and we won 4-0, my friend. And that is United. Now imagine Leicester. Leicester are much more stronger, my friend.
Chelsea is not losing.
Oh my
God. Nicolette, you lag with him forever on that. Give me your scoreline prediction. You said a Leicester victory.
Yeah, I'm so 50-50 because if Lampard lines up well, Chelsea are beating these guys 2-0. But if they don't, it's the other way around. Leicester is beating them 2-0.
So if okay, I get you. Salim, prediction?
Again for me, Tammy Abraham as a number 9 is so predictable. Yeah. Giroud is not because of his cute little movements. So for me, I will say, if all the Waikezaji, they are watching the show, I'm going either way. It might just go either.
You see,
a draw as well.
We are stuck.
You're sitting on the fence.
We are stuck.
Yeah.
you and me, my prediction actually, I'm actually just there.
It actually, literally, Chelsea's win literally depends on how they line that team up.
We don't care about how the haters and the devil.
It's not about hating, just giving our opinions into the game. Of course, if Chelsea were playing a team like Sheffield United, all of us would have been here.
And even
Chelsea
if we saw, once Giroud went off the game in the Super Cup, it became so much easier for Liverpool because Tammy Abraham, they know he'll just be a number nine. And if you have a number nine who is so predictable, there's nothing he brings to the
Giroud
table.
Giroud also has that physical presence where he'll give Van Dijk, he was giving Van Dijk a bit of a battle. But anyway, our opinions on Chelsea don't matter.
Yeah, okay, we are done.
So give me your score prediction.
We are done. My apologies.
With your Black Sox, give me your score.
My prediction is very simple. Chelsea is winning.
How many goals?
3-0. They're not scoring.
Okay.
But I will call you and check up on you.
Don't call me.
Don't
call me.
The devils
or whoever you call yourself, you're always for the bad thing.
Chelsea, I see you guys conceding. I do. Even though you're winning, even though you're going to win, I see probably.
With all that pace, at least that open football you're playing now, it plays right in the hands of Leicester.
Mimi nataka kuambia mwekezaji kitu kimoja, especially mwekezaji ambaye ni Chelsea. We are a good team compared to last season. I mean, okay, let me not compare. But this season, we are so prepared. We are so prepared that hiyo Leicester ambayo wanaongelelea hapa. Sisi hatuitambui. Kuna devil, kuna sijui nini. Hawa ni haters. Don't listen to them. Weka kichwa Chelsea na mse utalipa nyumba at the end of the month.
Your presence on social media is so strong. Unaambia watu waeke kichwa Chelsea. Alafu watu waeke mabibi zao. Let's they come and beat you.
Si hata waeke madada zao. Unajua mimi sishiki mtu mkono.
They'll come and take your
wife. Apana.
Hawa watu wanataka upoteze do. Weka kichwa Chelsea.
Na
uende kulala.
You're misleading them.
Ungojee game ya Manchester, weke Wolves na ulale.
You're misleading investors, man.
I am not.
Listen, Bapitz, because you have about, I think, 3 minutes, if I'm not wrong. Now, quickly, we're going to touch on. No, we're not going to go deep into the game, United Wolves, but since you'll be here on Monday.
Yes.
Your thoughts, United vs. Wolves on Monday. I know you are waiting for this. You had begged me yesterday.
Mama, I'll let you talk. I'll respond to you on Monday.
Mama, yangu. Baba yangu, muna gongo, hii niyo enu ya kwanza, ya kupigwa.
Hey, you're doing the Pepe celebration.
Munaenda kwao, unajua timuoni vizuri.
Because of the light.
She's shining. Let me tell you. Hiyo ndio, enu ya kwanza muna pigwa. Chelsea inashinda hapa. Sikiza, Chelsea inashinda hapa, ninyo muna shindo hapa. Na sisi tutawachekelea venye mulikuwa muna tufanya. Aki.
But Delvin, let me remind you of last season. Every time Bar said Leo ndo siku ya Manchester United kuchapa, we would win.
That I remember. But then again, okay, now let's touch a little bit onto this game. We already mentioned this is a game that probably United will have problems getting that counter-attacking game of theirs playing.
You know, Wolves,
given Wolves' strategy.
Wolves' strategy and Wolves' gameplay, every big five team fears Wolves.
Because of they sit back and they hit on the counter as well.
And they have a very strong, let's say, Portuguese.
That Portuguese
players.
Contingent there is.
Delvin, somebody is predicting your game. Please, the Manchester United. Lillian from Dagoretti is saying Manchester draw 2-2.
With Wolves?
2-2.
No, you say Wolves are not okay. Drawers. They are not drawers.
What about you said bigger?
Arsenal have scored.
Who has scored for
Lacazette. Thank you very much. Anyway, continuing back to matters of discussion.
This lad is so obsessed with whatever. Okay. But let me tell you, Nicolette, hii wiki mnapunguza kiherehere yenye mmekuwa nayo.
Lakini wewe unataka kusema hivyo ni kama unatupea blessings.
Nyinyi ni sawa, ni sawa.
Let's get Salim sorted in this game.
Lakini Salim, wewe uone hawa say.
I will say this. Man United are not such a bad side after watching them play because they have one man who is a match winner in himself. Nicolette is not a fan of him, but if he watched against Man United, against Chelsea, this is a man that if he wants to play football, he can play football. He picked two brilliant assists. So for me, I think Wolves is where the Man U's real test begins. Yeah, so if they can go against, above this hurdle, I think I'll tell you, if we get to January and just bring in a couple of signings, they'll have a say in the title race. Because
title race? Top four.
Absolutely.
I think title race is a bit of a stretch.
It will be top three. Yeah, let's say top
three. Kinanani, Manchester United
because
top three.
Man United have the quality in there. They have the quality. They can go and splash cash for 80 million a defender. Not because it's not that good. They trust in the quality. So for me, I think on Monday. It will
anyway,
be
Manchester haikushinda Manchester haikushinda Wolves.
It will be a draw.
Okay, Manchester haikushinda Wolves.
Was the big six. Even guys, they
let
were
me tell you something.
Yeah. Against City they really
even
brought
Liverpool,
a lot of
so hamna record poa kwao watawa
big six. The big six. The big
six. Because wewe pia ni shabiki wa Wolves.
And Chelsea they beat you guys.
They
beat Chelsea. They beat Chelsea.
Yeah, they did beat Chelsea in their home and then
let me tell you, the only team that was able to kind of hold Wolves last season was Liverpool.
So nini nakupea, nini nakupatia matumaini
anyway,
kwamba mtashinda Wolves.
Ba prince.
Mimi na bayana prediction yangu Monday.
We have to conclude the show.
Okay.
1.5 hours is gone. You still need more time, you.
I mean, he's showing up for 3 hours, Mazi.
Guys, let me just thank you guys first and foremost for coming. Of course, me, I'm rushing to go watch the Arsenal game. And I want to thank the viewers at home for tuning in and for sending your feedbacks that we have gone through. And yeah, just keep the conversation going. Of course, the likes of Nicolette Ba, active on Twitter. Salim, I just see you being tagged, but
when
you say one word stuff and
it disappears.
Pinterest
sana, we must say. Pinterest sana.
Anyway. Okay.
What's up?
Anyway, now do join me here on Monday, 1:30 to 2. I'll be joined with Salim and Nicolette as we take you through all the weekend's actions. Now, until then, do keep it sporty and enjoy your Saturday afternoon.